Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are doing fine at home. I am your teacher Neha and today we are going to see the 8th standard chemistry and the name of the lesson is Chemical Bond, Valency and Radioactivity. So children, in previous session we have discussed about the periodic table and the chemical bonding between them. So in this lesson we are going to see how the ions, that is how the electron will be removed and how the electron will be added so that there are formation of two ions. So let us see the what is there in the chapter. So children, this is known as a periodic table. So in the periodic table you can see that there are totally 118 elements, okay, and same way the last row will have the fully filled electron, that is the outer shell of this substance will have all the electrons filled, that is total number of 8 electrons. So now let's see what is there. So children, tell me what you can see over this. So yes, you can see here that there is coming closeness of the two different elements. So what happens here is, in sodium the outer shell is having only one electron. So to become stable or become a bond, what it is doing is, it is taking its one atom or one electron and it is giving it to fluorine so that there is a bond formation. So whenever this kind of bond is formed, that bond is known as a chemical bond. Yes. So now let's see what is there in chemical bond. So children, chemical bond will generally happen according to the periodic trend or electronic configuration. So in electronic configuration, all the atom wants to reach to the electronic configuration of the noble gases, that is the last end which I have showed you, right? Yes. So let's see what are the periodic or electronic configuration of these elements. So first element is helium and the symbol of helium is He, okay. So it is not written as the capitals, but it is written as He. Then neon will be Ne, argon will be Ar, krypton will be Kr, xenon will be Xe and radon will be Rn, okay. So these are the symbols of these elements. So helium is having the atomic number as 2 and the electronic configuration will go as 2. So you can see that the outer shell will have maximum 2 electrons only present. Same way if you are considering neon, so in neon the atomic number is 10. So how it gets filled is, first shell will have 2 electrons and the outer shell will have the maximum of 8 electrons and therefore the valency of this atom will be 8. And same way argon, krypton, neon and xenon, if we are talking, you will see that all these elements are having the valency as 8, okay. So the outer shell is 8. So this is why all the electrons or all the atoms which wants to make a bond wants to reach to the configuration of 8, okay, except helium and hydrogen, okay. Yes. So let's see how the formation of ions will happen. So children, the formation of ion of are two types. One is the form of positive ion and another is negative ion. So children, positive ion means, just see over here, an atom that loses electron. If an electron is going outside, it's going away from an atom, it will have a positive charge. Same way if an electron is additional, if it is having extra electron, then it will have a negative impact or negative ion. So children, there is a trick to understand this, okay. Let me show you. The atom which loses electron is known as a cation. What it is known as? Cation. And same way a substance which gains an electron is known as an ion. So children, how to remember the charges is, in every spelling you just see that the third substance or third letter, what it is, C-A-T, T here, right? And same way in anion it is I. So this T donates the symbol as plus and this anion represents the symbol as minus. So you can remember, like, cation is always positive charge and anion is negative charge. Okay? Yes. So now let's see how the cations are formed, which are positive electrons are additioned. So here you can see that in an atom from the outer shell, if an electron is removed, loss of electron, it will become a cation. So now let's see the examples. So first example we are taking for sodium. So children, sodium is having inner shell as 2, then 8, and the last one will be 1 electron. So if it wants to reach the configuration of stability, what it will do is, it will remove 1 electron. When it is removing 1 electron, you will see that this electron is getting removed, and here you are seeing that now it reached the noble gas configuration of neon, that is Ne, and see the configuration is similar to neon, right? And if there is 1 removal of electron, the symbol of sodium ion will become as Na plus, okay? This is the single removal of electron. So after single removal of electron, there comes the 2 electron removal. So what happens here is, if you're taking magnesium, the outer shell of magnesium will have 2 electrons, and if it removes the 2 electrons, it will become 2 plus, that is formation of magnesium cation, and the symbol will be written as Mg and 2 plus. So above also you can see that in magnesium ions there are only 10 electrons present, that is minus 2 is removed. So the charge will become as plus 2. Okay? Yes. And the last one here is aluminium. So children, aluminium is having outer shell as 3 electrons. Just see here, 1 and 2, 3. So what happens here is, if it removes the 3 electrons, it will have the valency as plus 3, and aluminium can be written as Al3+. So this is the trivalent valency, okay, which is a positive valency. Same way, if you want to talk about anion, so anion, I told that there is addition of an electron. So now let's see what are the examples. So the first example what I'm going to take is a chlorine. So chlorine is having outer shell as 7 electrons. So what we can do is, we can add 1 electron so that it comes to the configuration of argon, and therefore there will be 1 addition electron, and here the charge of the chlorine or chloride ion will become as Cl minus. Okay, what it will become? Cl minus. After that, there is 2 electron addition. So in oxygen, if you are adding 2 electrons, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6. To reach to 8 number, it needs 2 more electrons, and when it is reaching the outer shell as fully filled, it will become 2 minus, that is an oxide ion. What is this? O2 minus is a oxide ion of oxygen. And the last one is the configuration of nitrogen. So children, nitrogen generally lacks 3 electrons in the outer shell. So if it adds 3 electrons, it will become a noble gas of argon, and therefore the electron can be removed and said as N3 minus. So what is known as N3 minus, and this is known as a nitride ion. Okay, so this is nitride ion. Now let's see how the valency of an atom is occurred. So children, here you can see that the starting 2 rows in the periodic table are generally showing positive valency, that is, in this the electrons are being removed. Same way, these, if you are seeing from N to FeF, that is nitrogen to fluorine, is negative ion. That means in that electrons are added, and B and C, that is boron and carbon, are adding the electrons. So here you can see that if carbon is adding electron, it will become minus 4 valency, Same way, if it removes the 4 electrons, it will become a positive valency. So now let's see how the valency occurs. So children, here in positive valency, you can see that positive valency of sodium is generally having 1 electron at the large shell. So when this gets removed, you can write sodium as Na plus, right? So it is removing it and it is becoming a positive ion. Same way, if you want to see the second one like magnesium, in magnesium, outer shell will have 2 electrons and if it gets removed, it will become the configuration of Mg2+, and then comes to the final one, which is known as phosphorus, or here it is aluminium. So when you are taking aluminium, the outer shell is having 3 electrons and once it is removed, it will become Al3+. Okay, so these are known as the positive valency, and then comes to iron. So in iron also you can have 2 types of valency. So the valency can be +2, that is 2 electrons can be removed, or else 3 electrons can be removed. And this property shows that the property of variable valencies, that means many valencies. So here iron is having 2 valencies, one is ferrous and another one is ferric. So ferrous will have the charge as Fe2+. Same way ferric will be written as Fe3+. Then copper will have again of 2 valencies. One will be removal of 1 electron and the name will be known as cuprous. And another, if it removes 2 electron, it will become 2+. Okay? Yes. Then it comes to the next valency, which is known as silver's valency, and silver can be named as Argentinus. If it is written as Argentinus, it can be Ag+, that is 1 electron removed here, and argentic means Ag2+, and here 2 electrons are being removed. And finally, let's come to the mercury. So mercury, if it is written as mercurous, it will be Hg+, and if mercuric, it is Hg2+. Okay, so this is the variable valency. So students, now let's discuss about the negative valency. So negative valency means there the electron is being added. So in fluorine, the last shell will have 7 electrons, and to come to the stable configuration of neon, it needs 1 more electron. So when it is added, it will have the charge as F- because here 1 electron is being added. Same way here, if you want to discuss about the second valency and the 2 valency, here you can take the example of sulfur. So in sulfur, if you are adding 2 electrons to become it stable, the answer will come as sulfur 2-, and then again if you want to add 3 electrons for phosphorus, or it is known as phosphide ion, it can be written as P3-. Okay, so this is the way the negative valency is being discovered. So now let's see the topic of radicals. So children, radical means it is addition of 2 different types of atoms or elements. For example, aluminium is a normal single element, but ammonium is having NH4+, that means it is having NH4 is having +1 as its valency. Same way, the example of here, if you are taking carbonate, sulfite, then hydroxide, these are the example of radical ions. So generally there will be names like sulfates or hydrides or oxides, then there is an example of radical. So students, in this lesson we have discussed about how the valencies are being occurred, and later on what is a radical, right? So children, when you are going into the description box, you can see that there is a study material, question bank for your reference, and later on the self-assessment. Self-assessment will tell you how much you have understood the lesson, okay? Yes. So students, I hope you have enjoyed the session. Until we meet next time with a better video. Until then, bye-bye.